Hi, welcome to Love and Forever Evolving, where we are always and forever evolving. Hello, Aries. Welcome back, Rams. How are you, my loves? I hope all has been well. I hope you've been taking care of yourselves, eating plenty of fruit and vegetables, and taking in plenty of water, and definitely taking care of that beautiful, sexy-ass temple of yours, Aries, as it take care of you, my loves. Come on in, my loves. Have a seat. Get comfortable, okay? Grab your favorite snack, your favorite drink, all right? And we're going to talk about this thing called love, all right? Welcome, welcome. Shout out to the Evolving Spirit. Thank you all so much for your love, your support. I appreciate you. If you would love to become an Evolving Spirit like I myself, don't forget to click that join membership button that's down below, okay? It gives you exclusive discounts on your personal readings, your birth chart readings, your spiritual advice readings, any personal reading that you book with me. Each and every time you receive a discounted price when you become a join member of the Soul Tribe, okay? That also gives you exclusive discounts on your email questions and, most important, your love live stream questions when I go live, my loves. Shay, and welcome back to the ones that are new here. Thank you all so much for stopping by. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell on your way out, my loves. Shay. All right, so first we're going to switch it up this time around, Aries. All right, we're going to get some laughter, some enthusiastic, okay, some sense of humor here. We're going to use the Rebel Oracle deck here today. All right, I know I've been giving tough love out the past couple of readings for you all. So Source guided me to switch up the energies here, let a little loose here, put some fun and laughter and excitement in the readings as well, okay? So I'm going to use a different deck here and take a different route here with a couple of the decks here. All right, so definitely stick around for that. All right, I'm also going to, of course, continue to use the Love Romance Angel deck because the main meat and potatoes evolves love, right? So we're definitely going to still use the Love Romance Angel deck here and scoop around with a couple of decks as well that I have in mind for you. All right, and the readings here today, of course, may resonate for Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, North, and South North placements, all right? And cross watchers, welcome back, my loves. You are welcome here as well, Ashe. All right, so Source, angels, ancestors, protect my space and aura as I channel the messages here for the God and goddesses. Source, angels, ancestors, protect my heart most of all. What do we have here for the divine masculine, the divine feminine? Source, angels, ancestors, what do we have here? What do their higher selves need to know? Thank you. So we have two cards here that come out for you. We have some good shit is about to happen. Wow, awesome. I believe this same card came out the other day. I also use these cards for the daily messages on the community board. All right, so definitely if you're new here, go check out the community tab. I always give words of enlightenment, encouragement, inspiration, and I scoop around and use a different deck to give out daily messages there as well through the community tab. All right, so definitely check that option out as well for you all, okay? So again, Aries, back to you. Some good shit is about to happen, my loves. Yes, claim this fucking reading right now. We have over a million and trillion of waves of cells in our body, and each time that we speak out of our mouth, you are applying that to yourself. Okay, so you want to speak out. That's why affirmations is very important each and every day that you wake up. All right, because you're speaking this out. You're creating your universe. So again, Aries, some good shit is about to happen. So say that. Say that out loud. Claim it. Comment down below. All right, what's at the back here? We have don't let your issues fuck it up, Aries. Don't you fuck it up, Aries. Don't fuck this up. whatever this seals, I feel like this is a good opportunity here that's coming your way here. All right. Rather, this is in regards to a partnership. All right. In regards to your career, your finance, whatever this is that you're manifesting for yourself here. Okay. Claim this down below. Okay. All right. Yes. We're going to set that right here, honey. Yes. Okay. Because I say that because not too many cards in this deck here. Okay. These cards are not all about unicorns and rainbows, as you can see the slash through there. So for that card to come out and be as positive as it is, okay, that's definitely a sign of synchronicity from the universe. So definitely claim that. It was no accident or coincidence on how you were led to this video. The last card we had come out here is, it's not everyone else's fault, Aries. It's yours, okay? So that could be for a small... Oh, yeah, uh-huh. Yeah, someone may got up a little bit upset because I said that, okay? But however, my loves, okay? We evolve over here. We work on our shadow selves, okay? We believe in shadow work here, and we believe that this is how we are able to evolve and become a better version, okay, of ourselves. All right, so it's okay. All right, I've been there, done that, had to face myself, had to face my demons, okay, as well as you. We have a higher part of ourselves and we have a lower part of ourselves. The source wants all of us, not just half of us, not just our higher selves. He wants our lower self as well. We have to allow that to come into balance with each other, all right? It's our duality of us. It's our feminine. It's our masculine part of us, I say. All right, so on the back of here, it says, you are a grown-ass adult. Yep, someone needed to hear this, okay? Stop blaming others for your shit, Aries. Now, if anyone knows the Aries, okay, look, everything you do, it's on behalf of you. Meaning every decision that you make, Aries, it's on the behalf of you. Every thought that you have in your mind, it's on behalf of you. It's no one else's thought. It's your own thought. So as you continue to think those thoughts, what you think happens, it begins to manifest. The more you focus on those thoughts, the more you think about those thoughts, the more you dream about those thoughts. It all starts in the spiritual realm first before it comes down in the physical realm. So whatever you're thinking about, whatever you may have been blaming others for, it's time to go within, my loves. It's time to go sit with yourself. Realize, why is this triggering you? Why is you making my cards fall all over this table for who this is for? Okay, and I'm giving this to you with tough love. All right, I noticed your last reading was a little tough love, okay? And I respect the ones that sat here, listened all the way through, and got the jewels and pearls they needed to allow their souls to evolve. Because at the end of the day, fuck the other bullshit. What we are here for is for that soul to evolve. Fuck the twin flames. Fuck the soulmates. Fuck the relationships. And we really want to get real with it. Okay, and this is coming from a whole sun sign Sagittarius. I'm gonna bring down the truth. That's what I was here to do. Okay, at the end of the day, before you return back to source, you came down here. Your main mission was to evolve and have a human being experience. So you don't have to come back to this lower density with these type of frequency vibrations and energies. Yes, it's all great if you're able to meet your companionship, your partner along the way, because they're here to help you evolve, rather if it's in a good way or a bad way. Ashe, and that is what those twin flames are for, to kick things up a notch, to help trigger you. And those are what those soulmates here are for, to help support you, help guide you through. That's it. That's it. Okay? You came in here alone, and you better believe you're leaving here alone. So appreciate where you're at. Appreciate where you're going and who got you there. Rather if it was in a good way, in a bad way. Because now it's time for you to look at yourself in the mirror, Aries, okay? And trust me, this is coming from a place of love. And I guarantee you, once you can go through this process, all right, then you will look back and be like, wow, I did that. I was once in that place. I was once making those decisions, but because I just sat with myself and see what made me upset and seen what triggered me, now I've become a better version of myself. A lot of people tell me this every day who has been here on this channel and who I have done personal connections with through personal readings. I see the growth in them. This is what this channel is about. If your ass ain't evolving over here, I don't know what the fuck you're doing. You may be in the wrong spot, but it was nice meeting you. Okay, so again, when you do this process, this is called shadow work. When you work on yourself, then for the ones who have done that, which is, I want to say congratulations, now good shit is about to happen for you. Now you're going to be able to meet people, go places, be in situations that are for your highest good. Ashe? All right, so wow, powerful, powerful messages there for the ones that can truly hold it down as the Rams. I appreciate you. I appreciate you for noticing that in you. Ashe. All right. So, wow. Definitely, if that resonated so far, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe. My loves, you are in the right place. And there is definitely no accidents or no coincidences. Okay. Wow. This is significant. This card wanted to come out as I was just getting ready to shuffle the deck. All right. So, yes, some of y'all, I'm glad. I'm glad that this message is even triggering the ones that it's triggering. Okay. Rather if you agree with me or not, but it triggered you. So that lets me know that I'm doing my job. All right. It says healing family issues. And some of y'all, this is what this is about. And this is where it starts. Right. As my grandmother always told me, it all starts from home. It all starts from home. How you are around yourself and your household at home is how you're going to be out here in this world. All right. Your love life benefits as you forgive your parents. Well, 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 Aries, this is where it starts. Okay. For some of y'all, it could have started deeper than this. All right. We came in this lifetime with this. We came from our last past lives that we lived over and over and over again until we got triggered. It takes you having to get triggered to put away old generational curses. Huh? You don't hear me. It takes general past lifetimes to deal with cycles, curses, generational curses to trigger you for you to recognize it and get rid of it. And where does it start? With family. With loved ones, rather if it was in a betrayal way or a good way, all right? Rather what your parents done, my love, if you plan on wanting to evolve and get up out of here, if you plan on wanting to tap into the love frequency vibration in the 5D realm plus up and higher and higher, if you plan on wanting to have a soulmate to come around to help you evolve, you have to forgive. Okay, how do you think angels, angelic angels, are able to be where they're at? You can't go back up to source, not coming back up within your whole self and evolving. If not, you will come back around and you will have to live this lifetime again until you get triggered where you recognize it. And part of that is forgiving. If you're not able to forgive, I'm going to keep the buck 50 with you. You will not be able to evolve. You will not be able to move forward. You will keep having these relationships that will involve trauma, frustration, hurt, pain. And yes, because it's us seeking love for some of us in the wrong place. And it happens. How? Because sometimes when your parents don't provide that for you, when they didn't give that to you, when you don't know anything about love or how emotions work or how to balance them or how not allow emotions to over control you, take over you, things of that sort. You chose your parents for a reason before you got here. Yes, you may not remember that because you wasn't supposed to. How will you evolve from it if you remember? All right. So take that into consideration. If you had a fallout with your mother. All right. If some of y'all had a fallout with your father. Okay. Rather if they're here or not, allow yourself to forgive. That card has been coming out strong this week for all of the zodiac signs. So don't feel like this is just pointing out at you. Okay. This has been pointing out at all other zodiac signs as I've been reading here on the channel here for the past 2 weeks, honestly. okay? And I've gotten so many cursed out words, people been cussing me out through the comments. But I just shake my head and I just move forward because I know that they're not in a place to understand. I respect the ones that are, and I respect the ones that are not. I've been there before. I got upset when someone told me that I needed to do this and needed to do this, right? Okay, so we're all on different timelines. It's okay. All right, when you can get to that understanding, when you can be in that place, because I'm already there. I'm already in that frequency of love. I mean, clearly you can see it by the channel here. Okay, but when you get an understanding, when you get to the level where I'm at, it's different levels to this shit. Then it won't mean shit to you what a person would say to you, because you know, you've been there already. You experienced that. Ashe? All right, so know this is coming from a place of love from me, my heart, and what I'm here to offer here on this platform. This is not to downsize or belittle anyone. This is to help wake that soul up of yours so that spirit can evolve. Yay. All right. I love you. All right. And that's coming from a genuine place, Aries. All right. So let's move forward here. Source, angels, ancestors. What else do my sexy ass realms need to know here in regards to their love life? Yes. Stay optimistic when it comes to your love life. I see that card trying to peek out. All right. Yes. You need to free yourself. Some of y'all have even given up on love. But some of you all, it's the reason why you're here. Something drawn you to this channel. Something drawn you to this video. There's no accident and no coincidences here. We got free yourself. It's time to take back control of your life. Yes, some of y'all, you could have had energies around you, family members, loved ones. All right. I'm hearing enemies, okay, that may have tried to keep you in a box here, keep you in this gate, try to control you. And now it's time for you to control yourself. You're the first zodiac sign, okay? You're the first one out the gate. This is how you know how to do things on your own. Honestly, you don't need anyone, okay? Yes, we always need help along the way. We could always use help along the way. But when it comes to us and our individual soul and purpose and what we're destined here to do, you can do that just by yourself. Once you allow yourself to go within and feel what the feelings are that you're feeling here and allow yourself to heal from them, okay? Because I feel like for so long you have felt like you've been trapped. You have felt like this could have even been a relationship that you were involved in, or a particular energy here has tried to trap you on purposely here. Because sometimes people can see your power in you before you can even see it. Come on now. It's getting a little deep in here. Speak, spirit. Speak, spirit. All right. And this is why some of y'all even giving up on your love, because of the type of relationships that you dealt with, the type of situations that you have been in growing up. All right. And the things that you have experienced, and you know, you just don't want to go there. I get it. Been there, done that, got this t-shirt. All right. But know that you are deserving of love like anyone else on this green planet. Okay. Let's get one more card. Source, angels, ancestors. What else do realms need to know when it comes to their love life here for the month of May? What else? Guardian angels and ancestors. What do we have for the realms? Wow. Okay. We have a lot come out there. Yeah. Look at you. Attraction. You attract romantic love, Aries, by enjoying this moment fully. So as you stop and you smell the roses, as the more you love yourself, as the more you pay attention to yourself, as the more you put your phone down, as the more you put that remote down, as the more you tune in with yourself, give yourself that same love that you're seeking for outside of you, you don't think that's going to come back? But the more you look outside of you and you search for someone else to love you, simply because for some of you, all your parents didn't give you that nourishing, that loving, and that care. And it's okay, because I'm helping you to recognize this, okay? But however, we have to seek within first, all right? Because you will be forever going around in this gate and being trapped, right? You have to seek the love that's within you. It's ready. It's open to give and receive. You just have to be open to receive it, okay? I love you. You know it. You better fucking believe it. Yes, I can't make this up. Let go of control issues. Allow this situation to unfold naturally. Allow the divine to step in. All right. And this is what's crazy, because this is what's going to trigger you to put you on your spiritual path, to put you in front of yourself, to see your soul, to see who you truly are behind this avatar that you're in. Okay, you can appreciate where your parents allow you to be and become and who you are and where you're at right now. But now it's up to you. You have to get back control of your life and not try to control the situations or what people may have done to you in the past and how they portray you. Fuck even your own parents. Because some parents may have wanted you to do what they wanted you to do and live this type of life. But at the end of the day, the older you get, you're going to realize and your soul is going to tell you, no, Aries, this is what you're here to do. This is what you're meant to do. I'm here for you. You are here for me. We are here to evolve together. Okay, so don't worry about what other people got to say about you or who you're with or what you're doing or what you're wanting to do, what your purpose is. At the end of the day, you came up in here alone, and at the end of the day, you leaving up out here. So if you're trying to be here, people please this relationship. And then when you get up out of here, when you transform over, when you kick the bucket, and then your ancestors, your angels gonna be like, well, what was you doing down there? Well, what did you get out of it? Now you got to go back because you didn't get the whole point of the sole purpose of for you. You too busy please everybody else and didn't please yourself. This is a deep conversation we're having here, okay? I know only a many few are called. Everyone is called, but only a few will go. All right? Engagement. Your love life is extending, Aries, to a higher level of commitment. Yes, you are evolving. You are evolving. And some of y'all, it may be feeling a little uncomfortable to you because it's something that you're not used to. But you feel it, all right? Because it's allowing you now to see things that some of y'all may didn't even want to see. You didn't want to hear. Fuck, you didn't even want to know. But I guarantee you, once you now have been open and revealed these things about people, family, your mother, your father, people that you couldn't even imagine, the picture is bigger than your parents. It's bigger than your family because it's your soul. These are lessons that you were meant to come down here and experience with these people. It wasn't no accident that you chose the parents that you chose. You chose these parents because these parents was going to do the opposite of what you are looking for. Okay? Do the research on that. If they didn't give you the love, the affection that you need, or, you know, allowed you to be who you are and listen to you or gave you the attention that you've always seek, it's a reason for that. Because think about it. If they did do that, would you honestly be in the place that you are right now? Would you be thinking the way that you are right now? No. You needed to go through that so now you can seek that within. My loves, all right, because you wouldn't be able to come down the line here and get to this point and be able to engage with someone that's just like you, Aries, that went through the same process as you did, that experienced the same life lesson as you. And because once you meet this soulmate here, once you start engaging with this particular person, you're going to be like, wow, I wouldn't have wanted it any other way. All right. And some of you all are now recognizing this. Some of y'all have already met this person and some of y'all haven't met this person yet, but you will. If you're ready, if you're open to receive, if you're ready to look at yourself in the mirror and accept yourself for who you are and not giving a fuck about what anybody else has to think about you because you're golden. You are it. You are you. You're learning who you are authentically. And if no one can accept that, they're not meant to go where you're going, Aries, period. They're not. But I guarantee you, you will find like-minded souls just like you that are authentic. You don't have to hide yourself from these people. You won't have to hide yourself from how you feel. Because they will feel and see the same that you see in yourself. They will see in themselves. And that's how you find your soul tribe. That's how you find your soulmate. That's how you find true, genuine love. Welcome. You're in the right place. If you got this far along in the reading, welcome. It won't be no turning back for you. Ashe. All right. Yes. And because of that, you will receive passion. You will receive genuine love. Do you see how this male figure here, this masculine energy here, this divine, because he's up here up in the clouds in the universe, honey? Okay, this is a divine energy. You all have a divine partner coming your way. Rather, this is a divine masculine or a divine feminine. Okay, keep doing the work, and this is what you'll get in return. You'll get that partner to help you evolve and support you on this spiritual journey. And you won't have to come back to this bullshit. You'll be able to be evolved and go to another universe, another galaxy. Do you know how it is to have infinite love that doesn't have an expiration date? This couple here has done this over and over and over again. And they don't have no 1 o'clock, no 2 o'clock, no midnight, where they got to go find a fucking glass phony ass slipper and be told all these storytale lies. They've been doing this shit for eons and infinite times. Divine time, honey. Ain't no time run out. This is genuine love that ain't going to never go nowhere. So what kind of love boat you trying to get on? Real shit. This is real talk I'm having with y'all right now. Get your son. Scoop it up. Get these jewels and pearls and keep it for yourself. Knowledge is key. Knowledge is power. Knowledge is rich. You are enriching in your soul right now. This is what you call being rich. When you get in knowledge, that's going to allow you to be rich in your soul. Fuck mankind money. That ain't shit. But knowledge, wisdom will keep you up here where your ass will never come down. So allow your heart and soul to sing with joy, Aries. All right. And know that it is safe for you to love again. It's okay. I love you. We love you. Source loves you. Don't give up when it comes to your love life. Don't give up when it comes to you. You is the one to be able to make anything you want happen. You can put your mind and do anything that you want. Do not let this program as matrix make you think otherwise. I say, all right, so let's move forward. Let's go ahead and get the traditional tarot deck out and let's finish this thing up for you. Okay, powerful messages here so far, my loves. All right, you're going to be very much well evolved, advanced, because you're choosing your own spiritual path and no one else's. And some people are going to be upset for that. Some people are mad at me right now because I've said that, because my left eye is twitching. All right, and I don't give two fucks. If you don't like it, get the fuck off my channel. Period. Moving forward. All right. I feel like this is how you all are going to be feeling, because there's going to be some energies here. They're going to be upset because you're freeing yourself. You're freeing yourself from all the pain, the sorrow, the trauma, the hurt. All right. Source angels, ancestors, what can we take away from this beautiful spread for Aries placement? Source angels, what do their higher selves need to know? Wow, definitely if others of you, if the reading again has resonated with your spirit and your higher soul, don't forget to hit that big fat thumbs up, all right? Show spirit, source some love, all right? Like. Definitely, again, if you're new here, welcome. Subscribe, my loves. Be a part of family. This is what we do here. We evolve each and every day here on this platform. This is what we look forward to doing every day, that we have grace and breath in our temple. Ashe. And we move forward. We don't look back. We move forward. All right. What do Aries need to take away from this beautiful spread here today when it comes to love? Source, angels, ancestors of the highest light. What do Aries, the realms, need to know to take away from this powerful spread here today? Thank you. Wow, the lovers. I'm not making this up, Aries. You're choosing love. All right? You're coming into that companionship. You're coming into that soulmate energy. You're calling in your soulmate. The lovers, we have Gemini energy here, the number six. Number six is divine feminine energy. You're tapping into your feminine part of yourself, okay? And you are choosing you. And when you choose you, guess what you get? A person, a reflection of you. Someone that is on the same frequency and vibration as you. You're choosing love, Aries. Congratulations. This is what this whole reading has been about. Now, it could have took you some hell and hot water to get here, but you're here. You're free now, Aries. You're free, damn it. Congratulations. Celebrate. We were welcoming in your energy. Your energy is what welcomed in the spring energy. So I know you all felt it 2 times harder than I did. Wow, this is a powerful reading, Aries, okay? It's almost got me getting emotional here, okay? Wow, what else, Source? What else about this new passionate love? All right, and for the ones that are not here yet, believe me, you're going to get there. Start with working on yourself. Start with loving yourself. Start with meditating. Start with making a routine of adding yourself in the routine every day. Okay? And that's where you will grow and you will evolve and you will extend and get to this point. It's levels to this shit. Believe me, I know. What else, Source, do we have for my sexy ass Aries? Yes, I'm not making this up. The Sun card. You're going into a brand new beginning. All right, the cycle has closed out for you. You have passed the test. It's funny because this card wanted to come out in reverse here. This is Leo energy as well. All right, but let me tell you, honey, no more of that. Something, and when this card comes out in reverse, that tells me that something has been exposed. Okay, someone has been exposed or something has been exposed. Or what's going to be exposed here is that you're moving forward and you're not letting people control you and you're setting yourself free. Yes, and you're celebrating. Like I said, Aries, congratulations. You did it. You fucking did it. Four of Wands. Four of Wands talks about unions, meeting your soul tribe, meeting people that understand you and feel you and love you. All right. Four of Wands talks about engagement, marriage. All right. I'm not making this up. We have engagement here. So not only are you going to be meeting your soul tribe, but you're going to be meeting the love of your life, honey. Listen, lean in, Aries, lean in. Okay, look at all that. This is everything that I've talked about. This is everything that you're going to build yourself up to. This is where you're headed because you chose you. And now you're getting chose. Now you're being chosen. Wow, Aries. Wow. Wow, I'm speechless. We have judgment at the bottom of the deck. People are being judged because of decisions that they make every day, Aries, whether they're good decisions or bad decisions. But I definitely feel like this was a good decision that you're making. And now you're being judged in a righteousness way. And now you're going to be celebrated and beginning to have genuine love, genuine partnership. All right? So you keep pushing, you stay strong, and you get ready for this successful ending and new beginning of a cycle that you're going to have here moving forward. Congratulations, Aries. Wow, powerful reading. I love you, my loves. This has completed your love reading. Again, if the reading has resonated with your spirit and your higher self, don't forget to like, subscribe, hit that notification bell. I am available for personal readings. If you would love to book a personal reading in regards to your spiritual path, your spiritual journey, if you're needing to look up your birth chart and get an understanding of yourself and who you are, I am available for that, as well as any personal readings in regards to your relationship. All right. All the details is down below in the description box, my loves. I love you, Aries. You take care. I'll see you soon and I'll talk to you soon. Mwah! Bye-bye.